Welcome to this lecture video. In this video, I am going to explain problems on modern physics, which comes under module number 4 of engineering physics prescribed by VTU. So let us go to the problems now. So problem number 11. So previously we are already discussed some problems. So in this video, I am going to start with problem number 11. Calculate the energy of electron that produces Bragg's diffraction of first order at glancing angle of 22 degree when incident on crystal with interplanar spacing of 1.8 electron volts, 1.8 angstrom. So here the value of n is 1 and theta is 22 degrees and the interplanar distance is 1.8 angstrom, that is 1.8 into 10 to the power of minus 10 meter, and h is 6.63 into 10 to the power of minus 34 joule second, and mass is given as 9.1 into 10 to the power of minus 31 kg. Here we have to calculate what is lambda and E. So as according to Bragg equation, lambda is equal to 2d sin theta by n. So substitute the value of d, theta and n here. So d is 1.8 into 10 to the power of minus 10 and theta is 22 degrees and the value of n is 1. On simplification, the value of lambda is 1.348 into 10 to the power of minus 10 meters. Then we know that lambda is equal to h by square root of 2me. So on this we can write E is equal to h square by 2m lambda square. Substitute the value of h, m and lambda here. Then on simplification, the value of E is 83.07 electron volts. Similarly, by another method, E is equal to h square by 2m lambda square E. So by this method, if you substitute the value of h, m, lambda and E, and on simplification, the value of E is found to be 83.07 electron volts. This is what the solution for the given problem. The problem number 12, find the energy of the neutron in electron volts whose de Broglie wavelength is 1 angstrom. So here lambda is 1 angstrom, that is 1 into 10 to the power of minus 10 meter, h is 6.63 into 10 to the power of minus 34 joule second, and mass of the electron, that is mass of the neutron is given, that is 1.678 into 10 to the power of minus 27 kg, and charge on the electron is found to be 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulomb. So what is the energy associated with the neutron now? So we know that lambda is equal to h by square root of 2me. So E can be written as h square by 2m lambda square. So on substituting the value of h, m, e and lambda square, so we can write the value of e as h square by 2me lambda square electron volts. So substitute the value of h, m, e and lambda here, and on simplification the value of e can be written as 0.082 electron volts. So this is what the solution for the given problem. The 13th one is, an electron is confined to a box of length 10 to the power of minus 9 meter. Calculate the minimum uncertainty in its velocity. So here the value of delta x is given as 10 to the power of minus 9 meter and h is 6.63 into 10 to the power of minus 34 joule second and m is 9.1 into 10 to the power of minus 31 kg. So what is delta v? Uncertainty in the velocity. So as according to Heisenberg uncertainty principle, delta x into delta p is greater than or equal to h by 4 pi. Further, delta p can be written as m into delta v. Therefore, delta v can be written as delta v is greater than or equal to h by 4 pi m delta x. Substitute the value of h, m and delta x here. And on simplification, the value of delta v, that is uncertainty in the velocity, is equal to 58 into 10 to the power of 3 meter per second. This is what the solution for this problem. 14th one, Compute the de Broglie wavelength for a neutron moving with 1/10th part of the velocity of light. So here V is given as C by 10, where C is velocity of light, that is 3 × 10⁸. So V can be written as 3 × 10⁸ by 10, that is equal to 0.3 × 10⁸ meter per second. And H is 6.63 × 10⁻³ joule second. And mass of the neutron is 1.678 × 10⁻²⁷ kg. And the velocity of light is given as 3 × 10⁸ meter per second. So what is the de Broglie wavelength associated? That is lambda. So we know that lambda is equal to H by mv. That is equal to 6.63 × 10⁻³⁴ divided by 1.678 × 10⁻²⁷ × 0.3 × 10⁸. On simplification, the value of lambda is calculated as 1.317 × 10⁻¹⁴ meter. So this is what the de Broglie wavelength associated with the moving neutron. The 16th problem, a spectral line of wavelength 546.1 nanometer has a width 10⁻⁵ nanometer. Estimate the minimum time spent by electrons in the excited state during transitions. So H is 6.63 × 10⁻³ joule second, and lambda is 546.1 nanometer, and what is delta T? So we know that delta E is equal to hc by lambda, and further delta E into delta T is greater than or equal to h by 4 pi. Therefore delta T is greater than or equal to lambda by 4 pi into c. By substituting the value of lambda and c here, we get the value of delta T as 1.45 × 10⁻⁙ seconds. So this is what the solution for this problem. Calculate the momentum of the particle and de Broglie wavelength associated with an electron with a kinetic energy of 1.5 keV. So E is equal to 1.5 keV, that is 1.5 × 10⁻³ × 1.6 × 10⁻⁻¹ joules, and H is 6.625 × 10⁻³ joule second, and charge on the electron is 1.6 × 10⁻⁹ coulomb, and m is 9.1 × 10⁻³ kg. So what is the momentum p and the wavelength lambda associated with the electron? So we know that momentum p is equal to square root of 2 me. So substitute the value of m and e here. On simplification, the momentum P is equal to 2.09 × 10⁻²⁷ kg meter per second. And further, lambda is equal to H by P. Substitute the value of H and P here. Then on simplification, the value of lambda is 3.17 × 10⁻¹ⁱ meter. So this is what the solution for the given problem. The problem number 18. An electron is bound in one-dimensional potential well of width 0.18 nanometer. Find the energy value in electron volt of the second excited state. So for second excited state, the value of N is 3, and the value of A is given as 0.18 nanometer, and H is 6.63 × 10⁻³⁴ joule second, and M is 9.11 × 10⁻³⁹ kg. And charge on the electron is 1.6 × 10⁻⁹ coulomb. So what is the value of E2, that is the energy of the electron in the second excited state? So we know that En is equal to n²h²/8ma², so many joules, or En is equal to n²h²/8ma²×E, there so many electron volts. So substitute the value of N, H, M and A here, and also the charge on the electron. So on simplification, the value of E2 is timed as 1.675 × 10⁻¹⁷ joules. So divide this value by charge on the electron, then the value of E2 is found to be 104.7 electron volts. So second method, En is equal to m² h² by 8 ma² E, into electron volts. So E2 is written as 3 square into 6.63 into 10 to the minus 34 volt square divided by 8 m a square and e. That value have to substitute. Then on simplification, the value of E2 is equal to 104.7 electron volts. So by both the methods, the value of energy associated with the electron in the second excited state is observed to be 104.7 electron volts. So this is what the solution for the given problem. The 19th problem is calculate the energy in electron volt for the first excited state of an electron in an infinite potential well of width 2 angstrom. So here n is 2 and the value of A is given as 2 angstrom and H is 6.63 10 to the power of minus 34 joule second and M is 9.1 into 10 to the power of minus 31 kg and charge on the electron is 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulombs. So the value of En can be written as n square h square by 8 ma square so many joules or n square h square by 8 ma square into E so many electron volts. So by both the methods, on simplification, by substituting the value of N, H, M and A and also E in the formula, we are going to get an answer of 37.74 electron volts. So this is what the solution for the given problem. Thank you.